Do you have ringing in your ears? In this episode of Sound Science, we'll be discussing the latest update from Gateway Biotechnology on their promising tinnitus drug candidate, GWTT2. I'm Dr. Ben Thompson, and this is Dr. Suzanne May. We're both audiologists at Treble Health. So GWTT2 is a repurposed drug originally known as nimodipine, which is currently being developed as a nasal spray specifically for the treatment of noise-induced tinnitus. Early studies using an animal model of tinnitus have demonstrated effectiveness of nimodipine and the GWTT2 drug. This is exciting, and it's different from an oxytocin nasal spray that we've discussed in another Sound Science video. The nimodipine drug stands out because it targets the abnormal neural hyperactivity in the central auditory nervous system, believed to be a key factor in tinnitus following loud noise. Recent developments have shown significant progress, with the FDA providing positive feedback on the pre-investigational new drug application, paving the way for clinical trials for this drug, hopefully to help tinnitus. The goal for this project is to create a safe, effective, and accessible treatment for tinnitus, which is a condition that has long lacked FDA-approved drug options. So we're excited about this at Treble Health.
So today we've prepared some objective data and facts about GWTT2. As Dr. Ben mentioned, the name of the drug is nimodipine, and is being currently developed as a nasal spray to improve brain delivery and reduce symptomatic side effects compared to oral and IV forms. The mechanism of action, in simple terms, is to help control the flow of calcium into the hair cells of the ear. When there's too much calcium that enters these cells, it can cause them to send abnormal signals to the brain, which might be one reason people experience tinnitus. Nimodipine blocks these channels, reducing the excess calcium flow, which could help lower the abnormal signals and lessen the symptoms of tinnitus. Currently, nimodipine is already an FDA-approved drug for treating brain damage after a specific type of stroke. It can be taken as a pill, or in Europe, it can be used as an injection. It is in the developmental stages, as we've mentioned, but there is positive feedback coming from the FDA. Planned steps include manufacturing GWTT2 for clinical trials, toxicity testing on animals, and stability testing under good manufacturing practices. Preclinical studies using an established animal model for noise-induced tinnitus have shown effectiveness in reducing tinnitus symptoms. And the clinical trial goals are to provide the first ever FDA-approved drug for tinnitus, particularly targeting noise-induced tinnitus with focus on military personnel. These facts highlight GWTT2 as one of the most advanced drug candidates currently in development for tinnitus treatment.
It's really exciting. As we know, tinnitus has treatments available, but sometimes it's hard to find something that's quick, especially hard to find something that you can take as a pill form. Essentially, there is nothing up until this point. So Dr. Suzanne, you're seeing patients every day in Treble Health, helping them with their tinnitus. At Treble Health, we're really excited about new research and initiatives to find treatments for tinnitus. There are current treatments and therapies that work very well for our patients, for example. However, we're very open to better treatments or complementary approaches. So Dr. Suzanne, you work full-time seeing patients with tinnitus, helping them through their journey. What does this mean for someone with tinnitus about this hopeful new drug approach?
I think for patients, this is some hopeful information that they're doing research and bringing new drugs and medications for treating tinnitus to the masses. And I found that it's a very hopeful thing, and I'm excited for the future.
Yeah. And I know a lot of our patients, they're looking for, a cure or the best treatment available. What they eventually find is that there is no FDA approved drug treatment, and there's no medication for tinnitus directly. There's also no surgery for tinnitus directly. So then we're left with, okay, what are the best treatments and therapies? And that's where audiologists specialize. That's, of course, the work that we do with our patients at Treble Health. It's focused on that. But there's this whole other part of it, which is the potential medical treatment with medications or surgeries that could get to the source or the root cause of tinnitus. And this group here, the Gateway Biotechnology group and the drug that they're studying, it's an example of saying, hey, there might be a way to simply with a pharmaceutical drug get to the root cause of tinnitus, either preventing it or reversing it. And that's really exciting. Of course, that's why we're doing this, to stay on top of it so that everyone here knows about it. Did you find any other examples of this kind of drug being used globally outside of the United States, Dr. Suzanne?
Yeah, and actually in Korea, they did a study in 2021 where they took, I believe it was about 60 patients, and they had a 67% improvement with patients with their tinnitus. So outside the US, they're already using this in human trials and getting successful results. In addition to that, nimodipine has already been used off-label for things like Meniere's disease, vertigo, and migraines, which also have a relationship with tinnitus. So it's exciting times.
Yeah, when I hear that on one side, I'm really hopeful. But on the other side, I have the experience of seeing different drugs and different exciting, hopeful studies come through that don't end up panning out. For example, the study that you referenced out of Korea, generally speaking, what we see here are small studies where the sample size isn't that large. And there's not a true control group in most cases. And there's some benefit with the approach that's being studied that can, for the average person who might read an article or look into that study, they might think, oh my goodness, there's something coming down the pipeline that's going to be ready in the next few years, and I'm going to take a drug and my tinnitus is going to improve. But what we've seen here is that, you know, things like Odo-313, for example, which was which got much further along in the clinical studies. I mean, I even had patients personally who were in those clinical studies out of Florida. It just didn't pan out. So we need to be patient here. And the point that I wanted to bring up to everyone listening is it's important to follow these. And if you need hope with your ears and with your tinnitus, then it's extra valuable to stay on top of the newest research, knowing that there are professionals who are devoting their careers to this, right? But on the other side, don't delay treatment for something that has a low likelihood of panning out to be better than the existing treatments or the existing therapies. So I think it's okay to balance that. It's necessary to balance that. I don't want people to just wait for these potential cures and not do anything. That's a very all or nothing approach. And I actually think that's against what the person's true goal is, which is to live a full and productive life, not bothered or affected by their ears. What do you think when you reference your patients, you know, the people who talk to you every day, what other key points should we mention for folks in our community?
Yeah, two things I always tell people when it comes to drugs like this: be cautiously optimistic. You know, we can always keep that kind of in the back of our minds that they are working on this. But then the second part is there are gold treatment standards that we're already out there doing that have been tried and true and tested. So do the things that you know that can help you. And then later down the road, if something like this does come to fruition, then you can address it at that time. So cautiously optimistic, but while continuing to do the things that you know that can help.
And I would consider at this stage, this drug, the nimodipine and the Gateway Biotechnology Group, it's an experimental phase, right? They're still experimenting. Going from animal models to actually clinical studies is a massive leap that often research groups fail, just in terms of going from animals to human subjects. And then to actually prove that it beats placebo in a human subject has just historically been very hard for tinnitus. It's been tried. You know, probably the most notable one I mentioned, the Odo-313, that had millions and millions of dollars of funding behind it. It had a biopharmaceutical company who, you know, funded the studies. It had the FDA, of course, like approving the clinical trials. But after numerous clinical trials, they rightfully said, hey, this doesn't beat placebo. And that's actually the thing that I love the most about the pharmaceutical study of tinnitus solutions and potential drugs, is that it's very clear, black and white, does it beat placebo or not? Whereas in other types of devices or, you know, treatment approaches, sometimes it's hard to have the funding required to have a true placebo group. And when it's not a pill, when it's something you wear in your ears or something that you you perceive through your skin or your sensory system, it's somewhat hard to have a true placebo group. So I really love that about this.
I agree.
So what do you think? Nimodipine, it's a drug that is being studied and can potentially be used to help ringing in the ears or tinnitus. We're both audiologists here at Treble Health, Dr. Suzanne and I. We're fully committed to helping people with tinnitus live the best life they possibly can. And trust us when we say real treatments and success stories are out there. We feature many of them, so maintain that hope. And we're going to keep monitoring studies like this on our Sound Science episodes here on the Treble Health YouTube channel. Dr. Suzanne, any final words or words of hope for our patients?
I always love to end with words of hope because there is hope out there. Having tinnitus myself and going through using sound therapy and other techniques to get my tinnitus into a better place, I know that it can happen. And I always want to kind of spread that word that you can get better. So hang in there, okay?
Perfect. Guys, on the screen right now, you'll see an option to schedule a free consultation with Treble Health. So just click that button. If you have tinnitus and are looking for different solutions or wondering what can I do about this, we have this service available for free. Just click the button on the screen right now. You'll be able to speak to a specialist from Treble Health. Dr. Suzanne, thanks so much. And guys, we'll see you on the next Sound Science episode.